Hello, it's Thursday the 6th of August. Hope you're all staying well. Just a quick vlog. I've made a bit of a change to the games room. I've added something which is quite good for gaming. So what do you think of this?
Well, apart from my lovely gaming chair, it's very, very nice. And there's my desk set up. I've added some LED lights at the back of the desk just to sort of bling it up a bit. My bestest thing is I now have a large 60-inch display. There's my monitor over there. That's my little 24-inch. And now we've got a 60-inch display for gaming. So we can do, train sim and whatever. It's really good and works quite well. So, yeah, quite chuffed with that. Very happy and... Even Silky the cat likes it. Yeah. Mm. Okay. There you go.
Well, I've had my week off, and Leslie's back tomorrow. I must admit, I have missed her, so it'd be nice to see her back. I've been dibbling about all sort of day watching videos and things. I've had a day watching comedy videos. There's two that really stick in my mind. I've got a couple of favourite comedians and a couple of favourite sketches. We've got a chap called Des O'Connor, who Malcolm & Wise used to love taking the rise out of. And he was actually quite a good singer, but he would never admit to owning one of his records. No. But he had a chat show, which was live. And another of my favourite comedians, Stan Boardman, was on his chat show one evening. Stan Boardman, his sort of punchline was... jokes about the Germans in the war, and remember, we're going back now to the sort of, 80s, 70s, 80s, so it was a bit different then, and one of his favourite stories was the Fokkers. Now, the Fokker Wolf was a German fighter plane, but the story he tells, he pronounces Fokker slightly differently. So, needless to say, it was the last live program they ever did on Des O'Connor's chat show. All the rest were recorded. I think it had a lot of complaints. So I'm going to share that with you because it's very funny. And also Mick Miller. Mick Miller was a great sort of 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s. I think he's still going, comedian. One of my favourites. So I'm going to share two sketches with you. Stan Boardman, who basically did the last live program for Des O'Connor, which for obvious reasons, you'll see why it was the last live. And secondly, Mick Miller, who does the Noddy program for kids on the radio. And he's a drunk alcoholic, and it's very funny. Hope you enjoy them. Catch you in the next vlog. Take care. Bye.
Can you imagine a fellow on the radio doing the Noddy programme for kids? And he hates kids. He needs kids like a moose needs a hat rack. And he's been doing this for 20 years, every Monday morning, on the radio, Noddy programme for kids, hates kids, and he's an alcoholic. Don't forget it's on the radio, and I think it sounds something like this. Morning, kids. Noddy Show. Are you all listening to your radios? Oh, what a little Noddy do today. He wakes up, doesn't he? Goes in the bathroom for a wash. Can you hear little Noddy? Filling the sink with water. Little Noddy's got a big sink, hasn't he? He said, oh, sod it, I'll have a bath. Then he goes downstairs for his breakfast. There's a milkman. Pours himself a cup of tea. Pour himself some toast. and a runny egg. Then he got in his car with his friend Gordon. Oh, Gordon. And he's going on his holidays to Scunnybottleland. And he met a Scottish Red Indian. Hawkeye they knew. And he met a Scouser Indian. Hang on a bow. Went to the cake shop in Glasgow. He said, is that a custard or a meringue? He said, no, you're not wrong, it's a custard. And he's driving through Scotland, his car stopped and nodded. He said, oh, my car won't go at all. Phone the AA man. He said, what's wrong, eh? Hey! Found there was no water in a rainy night, no. No water in the Weishy Whoppers. No water in the headlamps. He said, what's wrong with my car, eh, man? He said, shit in the carburetor. He said, how often do I have to do that? Have a super evening. Good night. God bless. Thank you.
I'm no fool. I want to be here next week. Get your hand off your hip.
What about...
Yes, tell us about your friend. Yeah. Put your hand back on your hip.
Tell us about your friend.
Oh, the Germans.
Who else?
No, everyone's asked me about the Germans because you say, well, did he bomb your chip shops? I said, yeah, but he bombed everybody's chip shops, didn't he? I mean, they bombed in Poland. I mean, they bombed Poland's chip shops. Did he have them? All right. Is he Polish?
I'm just blessing you.
No, I said Polish, Poland. I mean, did you see that fella on This Is Your Life about a few weeks ago? Charlie Polanski. He came over here. And he was walking down Oxford Street, and Eamon Andrews jumped out the door with his red boot and said, Charlie Polanski, this is your life. And he said, yeah. So he said, you're coming with us to the studios where all your friends are there, and we're going to tell us all about what happened, because you are a famous fighter pilot during the war. You shot down 25 Fokker Wolfs.
Wonderful plane.
Yeah, and... Yes, and so we went there, he said, Charlie Polanski, you're here now, there's 15 million viewers watching. Tell us what happened. He said, well, I was flying in a Spitfire over the English Channel. And I am in the Spitfire. And all of a sudden, I see in front of me two fuckers. I think to myself, I must shoot one of the fuckers down. So I shoot one of the fuckers down, and the other fucker went into the clouds, so I followed him. And I lose the fucker. Well, then I come out of the clouds, I look around. He's gone. And in the mirror, I look behind me. The fucker is behind me. Eamon Andrews said, hang on, Charlie Polanski, you've got to explain to the viewers that, you know, during the war, the German fighter plane was a German Focke-Wulf. He said, that is correct, Eamon, but these fuckers were Messerschmitts.